Hey everyone, Scott from Horticide, and you guessed it, I got more shit. We got claim sale shit, we got LCS shit, we've got eBay shit. So, let's get into the shit. Let's start off with some Daredevil. Claim sale. Obviously not this one. But Barbarian Kung Fu. I got some Daredevil from him. We got 377. 378. 379. 376, and that's it for the Daredevil anyways. Strange Academy, Trickery, this was the free book that he forgot to add with my last claim sale I got from him, so he dropped it in with this one. Hulk Pitt. I didn't have it, so I do now. I think most of these were all dollar books. Hulk Pitt, maybe that was a $5 book. Donald Duck, Halloween Scream. And it's random. Every once in a while, he has stuff like this. Found an Archie ski cover. And another Archie ski cover. I may already have duplicates on this one, on the 251, but for a buck or $2, whatever it was, I'll add it. And then this one was, this is one on my want list. Just had never seen it, you know, at reasonable price. But he threw this up for $15 and I took it. Toxic Avenger number one. So, very good claims. Working on that Daredevil run and picking up some nice randos. So now let's do some LCS books. First we'll do new book. Immortal Red Sonja. You may remember the previous video. One I picked up was not in very good shape, and I didn't realize it until I got back with it. So they gave me a much better one. Also in the new category, Bad Idea. Kind of a cool cover. And I picked up a few out of a back issue bin. Let's see, Cry for Dawn, number 9. This image offends women, by the way. Dell 4 Color, 1015. Peanuts, number 2. And then Dell 4 Color, 1205. Nice high grade copy of David and Goliath. This Peanuts number 2 isn't bad either. I did not have this one, so I was going to take it regardless of grade. This one I had in poor condition. So it's an upgrade for me. I'm not working real hard at upgrades at the moment, but this one was really nice. So I jumped on it. Yeah, let's see, how do I want to go through these? All right, so these were all eBay purchases from a single seller. A lot of you may have seen them on eBay. The Generations collection. And still don't know how much I believe about this whole thing. It's some guy, supposedly a 3-generation collection of books, all high grade. Not actually a pedigree. They weren't pedigree. But the owner who is selling them sends out a little COA, which we know, you know what COAs are good for. Talking about the generation collection. So, and not every book gets one of those, which is another thing I don't understand. But I will say these are all, well, you'll see. They're all pretty high grade. So we got Dell 4 Color 460. We've got 4 Color, and that one did not have a COA. 4 Color 729. Four Color 1021. You know, and they're all, this one's got a stamp here at the bottom. This one has a different stamp. Dell 4 Color 862. I mean, this is a gorgeous book. No, but there's no stamp on this one. There's no COA with this one. 4 Color 893. This is the one with the COA. And again, you know, super, super nice. And, you know, now that I think about it, I lied to everybody. This Buck Jones, this was not from the generation dude. But these four are. But only one had a COA with it. So, again, I mean, you can tell condition, they're all nice, but there's really, as far as putting a pedigree on them, I mean, I don't know. You know. So, anyways, those are great. Those are great. Buck Jones, Jerry Saw. This was all from another eBay seller. He had a few books that I wanted, and I was going to make a package deal with him. And I found this one in his store, so I bundled it in with these other four. And here we are. We got Dell 4 Color 460 Buck Jones. We've got Straight Arrow, issue number 13. Another Mager cover. Straight Arrow, issue number 12. This is a series I'm really glad I decided to jump on. These covers are all so freaking awesome. Straight Arrow number 8. Looks good, displays pretty well, but we've got a little problem down here. But, I mean, hey, from a distance, it looks pretty nice, huh? And finally, from this seller, Straight Arrow number 1. So this gets me, I'm getting closer on this one. I'm down to about, to count again, I'm down to under 20 issues now. Don't remember exactly where, but these four, you know, put a bite in it and getting issue one off of the list. It's pretty big. All right, another eBay purchase. Different seller. Totally random. Totally freaking awesome. From Fox Publication. Yes, Fox Publication. 1944, September of 44. Issue number 11, which is technically issue number 2. The Bouncer. You guys get a chance, look up issue number 10, which is the first issue of the series. It's a classic. I don't have it yet, but 5 issues 10 through 14 from the series. This one has the origin of Rocket Kelly in it. Just totally freaking weird. But there's a new series for me to go after. So everybody needs to look into the Bouncer. Let's toss in some art. This is something I picked up a few weeks ago, and it's just now showing up from fucking Dynamic Forces. There was a claim sale / auction on, on somebody's channel. The guy that just lost his job. I'm sure everybody knows who I'm talking about. Mint Hunter. James Mint Hunter Comics. That's who it was. And they threw up this sketch cover of Batman 75. Signed and remarked by Ken Hazer. And they call it a remark, but it's a full-blown sketch cover. And it was cheap. It was, I don't even remember now, it was like $40 shipped or something like that. And then, you know, what the hell? So I can already tell you this is better than the Dynamic Forces exclusive King Spawn number 1 CGC. Fuck Dynamic Forces. Anyways, that was that. Finally, we switched cameras for a second so you can show you guys a packing job we got on this one. So these are how these books arrived. They were in another envelope, but I'm pretty sure this person like took the tough R insulation out of their walls to ship comics. But they packaged everything really, I've never seen anything sent like that. I mean, they make this nice little, they spent way more fucking time than I would have packaging shit, that's for sure. But they definitely showed up safe and sound. safe and sound. So let's take a look at these. Again, this is an eBay seller, and I just made a. It's odd it came like this, because the guy has lots of comics, and it sold lots of comics, but it wasn't packaged like a comic seller. So we've got from let's see here. This is Premium Comics. We've got from 1943. This checks off a couple of boxes for me. We've got Blue Bolt, issue number 41. Again, December 43. We've got a ski cover. And it's an Infinity cover. Granted, it's not the greatest Infinity cover, but that still qualifies. And let's see, we've got a Chu F. King cover. I can honestly say I've never heard of him before, so I may have to look him up. It's usually the Blue Bolts are all Wilcox covers. But I'm sure there's Wilcox art inside. So next, from the same seller, is from 1948. Kind of fitting, it's December of 48. We have Big Shot number 96, a Christmas cover. And I don't know why I bought this, because I'm not necessarily a collector of Christmas covers, but it's in really nice shape. It's from 1948. And I just used it to bundle. I mean, it jumped out at me, so. Next we have from Fawcett Comics. This one will make Jerry the Jitterbug proud. September of 1947, we have the Marvel Family, issue number 15. Again, I can't say that I'm a big Marvel, Captain Marvel, Junior, Mary, whatever collector, but it was something I could use in the bundle. So it just fit. Hey, and it's kind of an odd cover. I mean, I guess I could say, if nothing else, I collect odd covers. Finally, the reason I started the whole transaction, and I still need to take it out and do a page count. We have, from May of 1944, from Street and Smith Comics. That ought to give it away. Super Magician, Volume 3, Number 1. This is a lower grade copy. Supposed to be complete, but you can see we've got some issues here on the edge. Makes Marvel chipping not look so bad, huh? Anyways, I got this book for $15. In fact, I think I paid $15 for every book in this set. Let me rephrase that. These last four, $15 a piece. So then that was why I kind of added a couple to the deal to do a package and get everything a little cheaper per book. Let me take that back. He wouldn't offer combined shipping. So it actually ended up being $20 a book after shipping. Anyway, still a good enough deal. This one will be, I've got to do a page count, make sure it's complete, but it'll be a placeholder because I'll end up upgrading to a little bit. I don't care if it's a detached cover, but I want the whole cover there. But this will be a placeholder for me. And I'm down to needing 17 issues. Sorry, 18 issues. I need 18 issues that I don't have any copy of. And then there's another 4 issues that I have a fair or poor copy of or incomplete and need to upgrade. So out of the 57 issues, I'm 56 issues, I'm getting close. I'm getting close. So 18 to have the full run, and then, you know, the other 4 to upgrade to actually have a full run of 2.0 or better. So we'll see how quickly I can snatch those up. I think I've got one other stack, saving that for another day. Saving that for another day. In case anybody's wondering, that's what my press is running at right now. Got a couple of books in baking. I do long and slow, not like other people. Long and slow. That's it. That's it. I got more artwork coming in. I got more books coming in. There's just more shit everywhere. And I will get to that in another video. Probably this weekend, maybe. I'll have some free time. Usually take half a day off for Christmas, so I'll have some time then to maybe make another video, picking up some books from a relative, and should have some more eBay stuff coming in. More shit to show everyone. So let's go ahead and wrap it up there. It's a good spot to call it quits. So don't talk to any of you guys online prior. Everybody have a great Christmas. Great holiday. I know I'm going to enjoy it. Spend time with the family. Take a little time away from your phone, away from YouTube, away from Instagram, away from Facebook, especially Facebook. Fuck Facebook. But take some time off. Enjoy it. And then get back to work next week, lazy fucks. So until next time, I'm Scott from Horticide, and I want to know what's in your hide.